is undefeated on this court this season. 10-0 in Mackey Arena if you go back to last February. And we are up and underway. First shot is up. Caitlin Harper just off the mark and quickly the other way. This is exactly what Caitlin Clark and the Hawkeyes do in transition.
Led the defense well, just not getting that one to fall just yet. It's interesting seeing the vision behind the glass with all the fans.
Clark kayaking, why not? What a way to start.
Yeah, Abby Ellis now a couple times. Nice job getting into the paint to create.
Again? Yes! Of course, 2 for 2 from the outside for Clark.
You have to find her in that transition defense, whether she's bringing up the ball or whether she's spotting up on the perimeter. She obviously cannot have any space.
Well, one thing Caitlin really wanted to work on in the offseason. Same is open at 8 p.m. Eastern on a Wednesday. And after those free throws, Purdue has taken the lead. Layden will pull up, wraps in.
Miscommunication there from Iowa. Nobody really picking up Layden off of the ball screen, just leaving that space for her.
Stolke on the block, cross court pass. Sydney Folter knocks it down. Folter off the bench, coming off a game. When you're the third ranked team in the country, everyone is going to give you their best effort. Gabby Marshall from the corner. Janae Terry proving that she has to be guarded.
Yeah, Iowa just not really dialed in defensively. A Folter, though, on the other end. That gives her 5 off the bench, but
hauled down by Kate Martin. And here's Clark. Transition, money time.
Swinging a golf club as well. She is an insane golfer.
Make it 3 threes, Kim.
Ooh, CeCe.
Those are those soccer legs we were talking about. Kate Martin just takes it away. She sees no one is ahead of her, all alone at the rim. And Iowa just wastes no time getting the ball up ahead, even if they don't immediately get into a shot. So back-to-back buckets by Kate Martin. First the steal and the lay-in, now the outside shot.
From 3 to open up this game, Caitlin Clark with 4 of those.
12-0 run for Iowa. Empty possession there. Jones holds the follow through, gets one to go. Didn't hesitate, did not hesitate. Katie Gerald's told you that she wants her team to play fast. Kind of how Iowa plays.
Yeah, she wants them. Oh, is that our second bank three?
Yeah, Abby Ellis had one, now Kylie Fierbach. We've seen that so far, 7-point game. We're hearing the band, oh, the behind the back pass and the connection from Stolke.
I mean, are you serious? She made it look so easy. It was just completely in stride. Ooh, I can't wait to see the replays of that.
So smooth, the dime. So we've seen her get involved, right? She's got double figures, Caitlin Clark, and now it's about making sure that everybody else gets a piece of the pie. Nice take by Abby Ellis. She says right back at you. Energizer Bunny is what they refer to her here.
First quarter, they were just slow, not energized, and now that intensity has returned.
Davis knocks it down, and Holly Davis. And that possession was saved by Davis. Martin puts it up for 2. Kudos to Janae Terry. She keeps going right at the nail of that defense. Intercepted by the Boilermakers. 2-on-1. A little run here by Purdue. Iowa's used to seeing a lot of different defenses, and that is exactly what Katie Gerald didn't want to happen tonight.
Yeah, Stolke got up for that rebound, really coming into that explosiveness.
Clark puts it up. Just needed a second chance. Well, they're playing for something. This league is so competitive. Every win is so hard to come by. Pivot foot for Stolke. That's an and-one opportunity for number 40. Just off on that one. Let's see how Purdue tries to take advantage. Jones met at the rim by Stolke. The passion from the sophomore. Down. Her field goal percentages actually go up. Clark tried to draw the foul. Referee signaled to count it.
Oh, my.
What's the verdict? Shooting percentages, 60% in that first half for Iowa, 42% for the Boilermakers. Caitlin Harper gets Purdue on the board here in the second half.
Yeah, really nice pop out.
Is on Caitlin Clark. They switch her off to Ellis. And a different defense. Clark left all alone. That's five threes on the evening for her. That's when you know you're calling it fair. Comes Ellis off the screen. Aggressive drive. They want to play through her. Inside out. Folter sets her feet.
Really nice look from Hannah Stolke.
That one's off the mark. 16-point lead is the largest. Clark puts it up and in.
Yeah, nice response for Purdue to get it up and out. But, ooh, Gabby Marshall knocking down the 13th triple for Iowa.
What this team can do without its superstar.
Yeah, you want to feel like there's next to no drop-off in terms of continuing to run your offense.
In terms of looking for her own shot. She creates for others, but Katie Gerald wants Janae Terry to shoot more. That's Gabby Marshall. 10 points, whatever the goal is. And then if you're Iowa, right, don't play the score. But the three-point shot teams have the ability to get back in it quickly. That's Harper. And one opportunity. Had a sign that said she drove 4 hours to watch Caitlin Clark play. Amazing to see her impact. That's Harper with the jumper. Well, in the last couple games, they pounded it in the paint, talking about the Hawkeyes. If you go back to their... Here's Layden, gets her first three. Nice to see that go in for her. Knows what it's like to be at the top, an Elite Eight appearance, an All-American. There's Stolke flying through the lane. You've just got a lot of passion, a lot of talent on this Purdue team. Marshall. The rim. You think she's at home. That's four threes for Gabby Marshall.
Coach looks to make any subs here, but doesn't look like she's looking down the bench.
A Folter on the glass. Stripped down by Ellis. And in watching Caitlin Clark, she tends to stay in, and they realize that fans are here to see her. O'Grady left alone, and Iowa still relentless, keeping the ball alive. I mean, if you're Katie Gerald, that's what you don't want to see towards the end of the game.
Right. No matter what the score is, you want to still finish out hard, stick to your fundamentals, and it is, you know, some new players in the game.
O'Grady back-to-back buckets. Iowa's 12th game that they've won by 20 points or more this season. And as the clock winds